The new Australian movie Drift comes out on May the 2nd here in Australia, and with me today is Xavier Samuel, one of the stars from the movie. Thank you for spending some time on the couch with me.
It's great to be on the couch. You do all your interviews on the couch?
I try to. Yeah. Usually ours is a green couch to match the set, but this
is fine. It's a good couch.
What's it like being a big star in Drift?
Well, it was a great film to work on, you know.
The hair's different. I noticed you've had it cut for today.
Yeah, that was about 90% of my performance, that hair.
Was it hard? Because the role that you played previously, you were in Twilight Eclipse, we know that you were in Bait, you've been in Newcastle, you've been in so many movies. Mm. How is this different to all the others?
Well, there's not as many waves in Twilight. But we were filming with, Miles and Sam and Morgan, the director, they all kind of studied together, had a lot of camaraderie and it's a different energy when you're working with people who've got a history, and I was really kind of fortunate to be welcomed into that kind of dynamic.
Did you have to do any training before you, because you did some of the scenes yourself, didn't you?
Yeah, well, that was one of the things that Morgan was really enthusiastic about, was getting the actors on the waves and making it as authentic as possible. So when I heard him say that, I was like, oh, I've got a lot of work to do. And I basically just started surfing every day and was introduced to a whole bunch of really great surfers who were around in the 70s and they kind of showed me the ropes.
Now, the film was filmed in Nanup and Margaret River, is that right?
That's right, yeah.
How long ago was the film made or filmed?
I think it was roughly like a year and a half or something like that.
How long were you over here recording?
We were about 30 days, so yeah, it was all very quick.
Was it an easy shoot or did anything go wrong? Did you have to re-record?
We were kind of, blessed in lots of ways. Like, it happened, kind of flawlessly. When the sun needed to come out, it came out, and there was a few kind of hairy experiences here and there. I got held under a little longer than I would have liked to be a couple of times, dragged across a reef here and there, but lived to tell the tale.
It's an amazing movie. I watched it only a couple of days ago. Tell all our people out there what the movie's about.
Well, I mean, aside from all the surf action, you're basically, talking about a story about two brothers who...
The Kelly brothers.
Yeah, they're fighting, against the odds to create a better life for themselves, and it's loosely based on the genesis of those big surf companies.
Like Billabong, Rip Curl.
Yeah, all those guys, they all started in backyards, and, so it's all the kind of obstacles that they overcome trying to follow their dreams.
You got some fantastic crew, part of the cast as well. You got some well-known Australians as part of it, and you got some new people as well. Great to work with those people.
Yeah. You've got Sam Worthington, who plays a character very different to anything he's played before.
Yes, I was hoping you'd refer to Sam.
There you go.
He plays a photographer, doesn't he? A bit of a travelling photographer, isn't he?
Yeah, he's kind of a nomad and kind of an eccentric character. And he gets around in this big bus that's painted with all these psychedelic colours.
He's very easygoing, isn't he?
Yeah, and my character kind of becomes intoxicated with his way of life. And
had you met Sam before the movie?
I hadn't, actually. But it was really, really great to work with him on something that he was really kind of passionate about. And he's a pretty cool customer.
And your brother on the movie, Miles, but what was he like to work with?
Well, he's also produced the film, so, mm-hmm. Again, the story is very close to his heart. And the character that he plays is much more pragmatic, and that's where the brothers differ. My guy's much more off the rails and kind of got that rock and roll attitude, so they kind of butt heads.
And he steals your girlfriend as well, doesn't he?
That's right, yeah. Well, these things happen, I suppose.
The movie comes out on May the 2nd. If you could urge Australians to support it, would there be a reason why they should go out and support this movie?
Well, I mean, all the surf stuff is for real. It's a great opportunity to see a massive wave on the big screen. And I think it's, the biggest wave in dramatic feature, so... I mean, aside from all that kind of surf stuff, there really is a great story here about family and fighting for what you believe in.
And tell me about Xavier, because I was talking to you off air. You're an Adelaide boy.
Mm-hmm.
You studied in Adelaide.
I did.
You became a big star. You went into Twilight Eclipse. That would have been a big thing for you.
Yeah, it was certainly unexpected in a lot of ways. I sent off an audition tape one afternoon and didn't hear back, and then when I did, it all kind of snowballed.
How do you feel? Like, you're still an Australian, you're still a normal person, and everyone sees you as a big star. Is it weird going back to Adelaide and pinching yourself and saying, this is really happening? Because you're quite young still.
Yeah, I don't know.
You just take it as it comes.
Yeah, I think you try to keep your feet on the ground and...
Because I noticed just meeting you today, you're very relaxed, very chilled, very normal. You don't. Well, a lot of stars have there's a difference of personality.
Yeah,
I think you're keeping pretty level headed and you're having a good time with it.
Absolutely. I'm really kind of grateful to have all these, I get to do what I love.
If you could do anything in television or movies, what would the ideal role be? Because the director's out there watching.
I wouldn't mind being a host on the couch. That'd be pretty cool.
Well, you know what? There could be a vacancy coming up over my dead body, but that's okay. No, would you like to do anything
in terms of the role?
Would you like to do anything else? Like, are you still young?
Of course, so of course. You know, there's.
If you could work in Australia and do something, would you do TV or would you stay in the movie side?
Look, I wouldn't shut myself off to any.
Does
kind
anything
of,
interest you? Maybe the morning show or.
I don't know. Look, I'm just interested in pushing myself to. To kind of, be involved in something that challenges me. And
where to from here? We've finished, Adrift is finished. What's coming up for you?
I'm going to head back to Sydney for a bit, and we just finished a film called Healing, which has got a good friend of mine, Mark Winter, in it, who's great, and Hugo Weaving, and that's set in a prison, or a kind of pre-release prison, about these inmates that... Based on a true story, they tended to injured birds as a part of their rehabilitation, so they built these aviaries. And
oh, wow.
It's really a very beautiful story. And
when's that come out?
Not sure just yet, but hopefully sometime towards the end of the year.
It's called Healing.
Healing, that's right.
Look out for that's the new one that Xavier's in. Thank you very much for spending time with
Thank
us
you.
Today. And I'll keep you in touch with that hosting position.
Yeah, thanks.
I'm sure something will come up. The movie will definitely come up. It's called Drift. It's coming out on May the 2nd. Please support it. It's Australian, it's different, and it's well worth a look and a support. And if we want to keep Australian movies and the industry going, we need to support it. Thanks for being on the couch.
Thank you. Appreciate it.